So there is a subtle body inside, and that we always give experience whenever we take sessions for youngsters, explaining them about the subtle body. We tell them, close your eyes, think about Taj Mahal. Can you see it? Yes, see it. So your eyes are closed, but still how can see it? That's the subtle body. So during chanting, it's our subtle body which actually troubles us. Gross body troubles during chanting is feeling little sleepy, that's all. Otherwise, gross body doesn't trouble us. We chant and we hear. But the subtle body, which is made up of mind, intelligence and false ego, that's where we come to know why Krishna says to Arjuna that uncontrolled mind is like an enemy. Because that uncontrolled mind is a major component of our subtle body, and that subtle body is the one which does not allow us to chant nicely, because we have not controlled the mind yet. And therefore we keep on chanting, but the mind keeps on wandering. Rather, if you realize, moment we sit for chanting, the mind, you know, kind of, if you have seen our this me and mine pantomime, you must have realized that the mind actually becomes uneasy while chanting. He feels that, the mind feels that, no, by this chanting, you know, I'll get purified, I'll get this thing. So it just becomes uneasy and starts running here and there. Therefore, Haridas Thakur, when he used to chant this 192 rounds, that is three sets of 64, 64 and 64. What he used to do is, the first 64 rounds, he used to chant like our regular chanting, what we do, chanting enough so that we can hear. And next 64 rounds, he used to chant in his mind. So 1 lakh times he used to chant regular chanting like us, and 1 lakh times in the mind. And remaining 1 lakh times is to chant loudly for others. So therefore, we should in our daily life also practice this, that our 16 rounds are done properly the way it is prescribed, so that only we can hear. And then other times we should try chanting in our mind also, because by that the mind is going to get purified. Somehow we have not yet reached that balanced point where our gross body is also chanting and our subtle body is also chanting. Once we reach that point, our chanting will be one of the best chanting. So therefore, this is how our acharyas have taught us, that, you know, keep on chanting in your mind also. Okay. And of course, Harinam Sankirtan, we follow that. The last 64 round which Haridas Thakur used to do for all other living beings. And inside this subtle body is the body of the soul, which has ears, which has eyes. That's the eyes which can see Krishna, but the soul is in such a sleepy state, in such a deep sleep, that we are not able to wake up. That's why we use the word awakening of the souls. That's why the bhajan jiva jago is there. Coming to the purport, which Srila Prabhupada says, that as the gross cosmic manifestation conceived as a gigantic body of the Lord, so there is a conception of his subtle form which is simply realized without being seen, heard and manifest. So actually, we are not able to see the Lord, we are not able to hear the Lord, which we are not able to manifest the Lord. So we expect these three things. Everybody expects these three things. So Srila Prabhupada has made very clear that it's very difficult. It's very difficult to see, hear and see the manifest form. But in fact, all these gross and subtle conceptions of the body are in the relation with the living body. The living being has his spiritual form beyond this gross material and subtle psychic experience.